To give the first fruit of the day to the Lord is one of the most valuable ways to show our love to God. It is true that a prayer that comes from the heart can move mountains. It increases your faith and brings you closer to God. Let us welcome our Jubal Choir to begin the great evening with a prayer song. And now let us all stand up for the prayer. Thank you, choir, for creating a heavenly atmosphere here.
The primary purpose of reading the Holy Bible is not to know the Bible, but to know the God, says James Merritt. Now, I call upon Ms. Swati, the student president, to read verses from the Holy Bible.
A reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verses 26 to 31. Then God said, "Let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth." So God created humankind in His image. In the image of God, He created them. Male and female, He created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has a breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything he had made, and indeed it was very good. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I request everyone to be seated.
Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success, says Henry Ford. Now I invite Dr. Reena Raj, Head and Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, to deliver the welcome speech.
Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and He will establish your plans. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. Greetings to everyone present here. The flags are flying, the balloons are ready to release, and it's a great day we had been planning and waiting for. On behalf of St. Joseph's family, I extend a gracious and affable welcome to you all to celebrate the 15th College Day and to commemorate our success, showcase our talents, and be grateful for our fortune. The year 22-23 has indeed been a roller coaster ride, just like the previous years, a time full of opportunities, a time full of learning, and a time well spent, being competitive at some times and a helping hand at others. It has been a superb period, months that have gone by and will never return. The true grandeur of humanity is in moral elevation, sustained, enlightened, and decorated by the intellect of man. Today, we have one such eminent personality amidst us on this auspicious day. We feel deeply elevated to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Anthony Louis Priyakumar Douglas, who is the Dean for Research and Development at Cambridge Institute of Technology, Bengaluru. Dr. Anthony is a gold medalist in MSc Computer Science from Madurai Kamaraj University, record holder in Masters in Computer Science and Engineering from IIT Madras, and PhD from Stuttgart University in Germany. He worked in Siemens Limited for 13 years and taught for more than 10 years in various universities, including Germany. He has 15 granted patents from USA, Russia, Europe, Poland, Hungary, China, and India. He has more than 20 research publications, including 3 from IEEE transactions. His areas of specialization are artificial intelligence, machine learning, drone computing, real-time vision-based analytics, novel sensor applications, wireless camera platforms, thermal imaging, signal processing, multiple hardware platform-based performance optimization, and mobile robotics. He has to his credit various projects with technical contributions and management. We are grateful from the bottom of our heart for courteously and gladly accepting our invitation and being the chief guest for this occasion today. We extend a genial welcome to you, sir. We now request our respected secretary to honor our chief guest with a bouquet as a sign of our love and welcome. Thank you, sister. We now request our beloved principal to offer a memento as a token of love. Thank you, sister. Dream to achieve and dare to conquer. You are a person who embraces challenges, believe in continuous effort. Indeed, your work ethics is a true reflection that inspires everyone to achieve the pinnacle. It's our immense pleasure to welcome our secretary, Reverend Sister Mary Lucy Juliet, who has always been a source of strength to us. Your endless commitment to this institution have helped us reach where we are standing today. We offer a warm welcome to you, sister. A million unlit candles and still darkness prevails. All that is needed is that one candle with light. Not only will the darkness be dispelled, but also the million candles will come to light. She is none other than our beloved principal, Reverend Dr. Sister Helen, whose hard work and commitment is the foundation of her achievements. And her understanding, supportive, and confident qualities make her a great leader too. With all our charming and cheerful greetings, we extend a hearty welcome to our respected principal, in whose presence million incomplete souls feel complete. We extend a cordial welcome to you, sister. We also welcome Sister Valan Rani to this occasion. Life is not about expecting, hoping, and wishing. It's about doing, being, and becoming. It's our esteemed privilege to welcome Sister Grace, respected principal of St. Joseph's Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Sister Teresa, respected principal of St. Joseph's Academy, Hosur, and fathers and sisters from various institutions. Your presence for this evening festivity adds glitters to our campus. We sincerely acknowledge your divine presence, as it is an explicit sign of your concern for us. We gladly welcome you all and wish you a splendid time with us. We extend a very warm welcome to our special invitees and our supporters of well-being of our college. Certainly, your presence amidst us brings us a lot of hope, and our future is being built on this hope. Welcome, everyone. No love is greater than mom's love, and no care is greater than dad's care. Dear parents, you are very much part of us. We acknowledge the part you play in imparting holistic education and formation of young minds. We feel deeply cherished to offer a pleasant welcome to each one of you. Welcome, dear parents. Genius is the gold in the mine. Talent is the miner who works and brings it out. Dear teachers, you are the real life miners and role models, the one who creates alluring ambience, inspiring and igniting the minds of students to explore the unknown. You have set a target for their future and have become instrumental in achieving their destined goals. It's a proud privilege to extend a warm welcome to you, dear teachers. We owe much to the members of the non-teaching faculty. Undoubtedly, you are an asset for us. You stand by us and coordinate everything on the home front. We wholeheartedly welcome all the non-teaching staff, technical staff, and supporting staff members of our college. Never get tired of doing little things for others. Sometimes those little things occupy the biggest part of their heart. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. We put our hearts together to welcome the treasures of St. Joseph's College. Yes, you students are the central focus of this event. You are the true performers today, and you make the event colorful. We welcome you, dear students. Once again, I extend a warm welcome to each and every one of you. We hope that you enjoy the event and that it enriches your experiences here at our college. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Our college has taken a step forward in the bygone academic year. It is a time for looking back to the past, for assessing our entire performance and development so far for a better tomorrow. It's my honor to welcome our principal, Reverend Sister Dr. Helen, to present the report of all the plans and results of achievements of the academic year 2022-2023.
Pleasant evening to all of you. The Bible says God is like a shield for all who seek His protection. 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 31. Esteemed chief guests, dignitaries, invited guests, benefactors, parents, professors, supportive staff, and my dear Josephites, I extend a warm welcome to you. This prestigious institution, St. Joseph's College of Arts and Science for Women, affiliated to Periyar University, was established in the year 2006 to empower women through education. It is administered by the Franciscan Sisters of the Presentation of Mary Coimbatore. With the motto, knowledge purifies, charity enhances, this temple of learning has been taking great strides to impart holistic education to young women, imparting higher education along with life skills with strict discipline. Equipped with noble vision and moral strength, our students are trained to face life in all its challenges and serve the society and the country with great dedication and commitment. The institution has been recognized for its outstanding achievements in academics, community service, sports, green campus initiatives, and women empowerment. The academic year 22-23 began with the theme Communion with Nature, which paved the way to find harmony with Mother Nature. With the grace of the Almighty, we Josephites have succeeded in making academic learning a pleasurable experience, instilling hope and understanding in young students. The annual day is a very momentous occasion for the management, faculty, and students. It is the time to celebrate our academic, co-curricular, and extracurricular achievements and revel in its glory and derive strength to continue our journey with renewed enthusiasm and passion. On this joyous occasion, we feel honored to have with us Dr. Anthony Louis Priyakuma Douglas, a very distinguished academician, as our chief guest. On behalf of the management, faculty, and students, I extend a warm welcome to Dr. Anthony and extend my gratitude to him for having accepted our invitation to grace our annual day celebrations. College Union. The College Union offers a friendly environment for student participation in all the activities. The College Union offers a platform for the sharing and exchanging of ideas and experiences in numerous facets of education and find its fulfillment. The office bearers of a College Union, President Swati, 3rd BSc Mathematics, Vice President Jarina Margaret, 3rd BSc Physics, Sports Secretary Vosia, 3rd BCom CA, Secretary Sabatina Mary Faustina, 2nd BA English, 2nd year head girl, Vidyashree, 2nd BSc Biotechnology, PG Representative Archana, 2nd MCOM, Joint Secretary Safina, 1st BBA, 1st year head girl, Bhavya, 1st BA English. Academic distinction. The administration acknowledges the tireless efforts of the faculty and students' display of academic excellence this year as well. Undergraduate courses, BBA, Biotechnology, Chemistry, Computer Science, Mathematics have secured 100%, English and BCom CA 98%, BCA Physics, Nutrition, Dietetics 96%, and BCom 95%. Postgraduate courses, Commerce, Computer Science, and Mathematics have secured 100% and English 70%. MPhil English 100% and Commerce 34%. Faculty, what sculptor is to block a marble, education is to human soul, Joseph Addison. Collegiate education develops the holistic personality of the students along with academic excellence. The prime reason for these remarkable achievements is the noble efforts of the teaching faculty in molding the young learners with care and commitment. The endeavors of faculty in updating knowledge and research experience enables them to be venerable professors. Here are the achievements of our faculty. 21 staff have published in international and national level journals. 17 faculty have published their 29 research papers with ISBN. 49 faculty have presented research papers at national international level conferences. 14 faculty have participated in national conferences and workshops. 37 faculty have served as external examiners in different colleges. 12 faculty members have served as resource persons for IR spectroscopy and surface imaging, application in agriculture, biology and healthcare, soft skill training, ICT in mathematics, vital tools for learning math, significance of research in social sciences, National Education Day, and International Year of Millet. 4 faculty have set question papers for their other institutions. 32 faculty have attended faculty development programs. 31 faculty attended various skill development and faculty training programs like literary festival, junior MBA, poem competition, lecture series. 21 staff participated orientation program on ISO audit training and certification process. 32 staff attended lead auditor course on environment management system, green campus audit, energy audit and hygiene audit. 80 members of staff have participated in various webinars. One faculty from each department attended non-mudalvan FDP phase 1 and 2 conducted by Periyar University, Salem. 17 faculty members from the Department of Commerce attended a faculty training program on junior MBA conducted by Ekalai Academy, Coimbatore. Conferences, seminars, webinars, workshops organized. Departments have organized various association meetings, guest lectures, conferences, seminars and workshops at state, national and international levels. The departments engaged in several noteworthy activities including Department of Commerce organized a faculty development program on the art of writing and publishing research papers and a webinar on freshers orientation for school to campus and money management and two workshops on research methodology in social science using SPSS and research methodology and a guest lecture on demystifying GST business and career. Department of Business Administration organized a quiz product launch, budget planning and two guest lectures on stress management and preparing yourself for employability. Department of Biotechnology organized a two-day international conference on advances and applications of biotechnology in the 21st century. Three workshops on herbal soap making, Institution Innovation Council, bridal makeup, soft toy making, and a webinar on research and funding agencies in India, and a seminar on future prospects of in biotechnology. Department of Computer Science organized a two-day international conference on prominent challenges in information technology and five workshops on recent trends in technology, CS, a pathway to success, management of intellectual property rights, a hands-on session on Python programming, Internet of Things, and two webinars on intellectual property rights, design thinking as a strategy for innovation. Department of Mathematics conducted two workshops on decorum of applied mathematics, Internet of Things. Department of Chemistry celebrated Ozone Day and organized a workshop on alchemy for agri. Department of English conducted a two-day international conference on emerging socio-cultural dimension in English language and literature, a seminar on citing, quoting and paraphrasing in research, and a workshop on career counseling. Department of Physics conducted a workshop on importance and growth of device quality single crystal for device fabrication, LED lights assembling and manufacturing technology and entrepreneurship, attitude and behavior development. Department of Nutrition and Dietetics conducted a workshop on food preservation techniques and a hands-on session on jelly jam squeeze making. Department of Tamil in association with the Government of Tamil Nadu organized Mabaram Tamil Kanavu, an oration by the poet Srimadhi Andal Priyadarshini and Samas, media person, followed by discussion with the students. Books published. Our college feels proud in acknowledging the ardent efforts of a faculty who have authored and edited quality books. Mrs. Anto Ramya, Mrs. Bobby, Mrs. Amalrich, Mrs. Niranjana, assistant professors of computer science, have published a book on relational database management system. Dr. Dina Suresh, head of the department and computer science, and assistant professors Mrs. Ashwini, Mrs. Jayanti, Mrs. Anusha Prem have published a book on problem solving using Python. Mrs. Niranjana, Mrs. Mageshwari, Sister R.K. Valandrani, Mrs. Kaveri, assistant professors of computer science have published a book Visual Basic 6.0. Mrs. Anto Ramya, Mrs. Shuguna, Mrs. Geetanjali, Mrs. Logeshwari, assistant professors of computer science have published a book Programming in Java. Mrs. Jayanti, Mrs. Anusha Prem, Dr. Dina Duresh, assistant professors of computer science, have published a book, Research Methodology. Dr. Dina Duresh, head of Department of Computer Science, and assistant professors Mrs. Bobby, Mrs. Amalrich, Mrs. Aswini have published a book, Web Technology. Dr. Dina Duresh, head of Department of Computer Science, and assistant professors Mrs. Bobby, Mrs. Anusha Prem, have published a book, Handbook of Flora of St. Joseph's College. The Department of English published a book, Emerging Socio-Cultural Dimension in English Language and Literature. The Department of Management conducted a certificate course, Beauty Therapist. The Department of Computer Science conducted a certificate course on Python programming and VAC hardware basics, impact of IT on environment, nutrition course. The Department of Mathematics conducted certificate courses on Python programming and coaching classes for CSIR NET, JAM and TNPSC. The Department of Commerce conducted the following certificate courses: tailoring, beautician, RE work, coaching for competitive exams, yoga, karate, typewriting, VAC coaching for CA, CMA and ACS and VAC tally. The Department of Physics conducted a certificate course on VAC basic circuit designing. Bridge courses. Following following are the bridge courses conducted by various departments. The Department of Management on Principles of Management for 1st BC and 1st BSc Computer Science. The Department of Biotechnology on Biotechnology for the Society for 1st BSc Nutrition and Dietetics. The Department of Computer Science on Email Creation, Basics of MS Word and PowerPoint, Effects of Computer Technology on Health for All First Year Students. The Department of Commerce on Principles of Accounting for 2nd BSc CS, 2nd BCA and 2nd BBA. The Department of Mathematics on Basics on Number Systems, Numerical Operations, Set Theory, Matrix Theory and Logical Solving for 1st BCom, 1st BCom CA, 1st BSc CS and BBA. The Department of English on Grammar and Functional English for all first year students. The Department of Physics on Basics of Physics for 1st BCA, 1st BSc Mathematics and 1st BSc Chemistry. The Department of Nutrition and Dietetics on Food and Nutrition for 1st BSc Biotechnology. Other departmental activities. The Department of English screened movies related to subjects of study. 13 intercollegiate competitions and 8 intercollegiate programs like quiz, product launch, budget learning, World Radiology Day, National Education Day, Stress Management were organized by various departments. Department of Commerce conducted Food and Trade Fair 2023 and gained rupees 73,500. Organized a skill development program on t-shirt painting. Science Expo 22-23 was conducted by the science departments. Following are the models displayed by the departments. Biotechnology 18, Chemistry 38, Computer Science 8, Mathematics 21 and Physics 11. Department of Tamil screened a movie Sadhanayalan on the theme Neerindi Amayadu Ulagu. All the departments celebrated International Year of Millet through various competitions raising awareness on the consumption of millets. The clubs and associations of the departments conducted various competitions like essay writing, models, paper presentation, origami, pirates, debate, elocution, caption writing, turncoat, PowerPoint presentation, masterminds, glass painting, cooking, adds up and connections, industrial visits. Department of Computer Science visited ISRO Hall and Visvesvarya Museum, Bangalore. Department of Mathematics and Physics to Visvesvarya Technical Museum and Jawaharlal Nehru Planetarium, Bangalore. Department of Management to Sekhfler Technical Enhancement Program Center, Hosur. Department of Chemistry to Immune, Odapalli, Dina. Department of Mathematics, Physics, Chemistry to Kerala and Kanyakumari. Department of English to Mysore and Computer Science to Goa. Honours. Mrs. Jelisha, Head and Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics. Mrs. Mahalakshmi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics. The Assistant Professors of Commerce. Mrs. Priya, Mrs. Vyani Janita Rani, Mrs. Vadivu, Mrs. Bonapriya, Mrs. Sengamalam, Mrs. Samundeshwari, Dr. Maithili were awarded Best Senior Faculty by Novel Research Academy, Puducherry, India. Dr. G. Bhuvana, Assistant Professor of Commerce, and Mrs. Sivapriya, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, received Best Women Faculty Award by Novel Research Academy. Dr. Thangamurugeshwari and Dr. Rajeshwari, Assistant Professors, Department of Mathematics, have received Best Young Research Award by Novel Research Academy, Puducherry, India. Dr. Joan Princeya, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Mrs. Aruna, Assistant Professor of Commerce, and Mrs. Saraswati from the Department of Management were awarded the Best Young Faculty by Novel Research Academy, Puducherry, India. Mrs. Aswini, Mrs. Jayanti, Mrs. Niranjana, Mrs. Logeshwari, Assistant Professors of Department of Computer Science, were given Tronacharya Award by REST Society for Research International. Dr. Dina Duresh, Head and Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, was awarded the Best Researcher by Mrs. Antu Ramya, Mrs. Babi, Mrs. Amalraj, Mrs. Aswini, Mrs. Jayanti, Mrs. Anusha Prey, Mrs. Mageshwari, Mrs. Shuguna, Mrs. Logeshwari, and Mrs. Geetanchali, Assistant Professors, Department of Computer Science, were awarded Best Senior Faculty by Nature Science Foundation, Coimbatore. Mrs. Niranjana, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, was awarded Best Woman Faculty by Nature Science Foundation, Coimbatore. Sister Aroke Valandrani, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, received Best Research Scholar Award from Nature Science Foundation, Coimbatore. Mrs. Kaveri, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, was awarded Best Young Faculty by Nature Science Foundation, Coimbatore. Dr. S. Geeta from the Department of Tamil has received Kural Kavinger Virudu by Eela Tamilar Peravai Pannattu Tamil Amaippu, Kavidai Tilakam Virudu by Satyamangalam Tamil Manjram, and Arivu Suryan Virudu by Success Academy and Foundation Salem. Dr. Sanguvathi from the Department of Tamil was awarded Kalvi Kalangarai Vilakku by Pasumai Vasal Foundation, Dindukal. Mrs. Eeshwari Boy, Librarian, was awarded Sirandha Noolagar Virudu and Noolaga Manimuguda Virudu. internal quality assurance cell. The prime task of the IQAC is to develop a system for determined constant and catalytic improvement in the overall performance of the institution through best practices. Two staff attended an event, NAC Accreditation Challenges and Opportunities for Quality Enhancement Measures, Roadmap for Colleges Affiliated to Periyar University, organized by Periyar University, Salem. Skill development workshop on e-content was conducted. Research. Dr. Maulika of Physics has received her doctoral degree. 20 faculty members are pursuing their doctoral studies. The college has produced 5 MPhil scholars. Students' achievements. Our students' achievements in extracurricular activities and academics have brought laurels to our college and enhanced its reputation across the country, giving it an extra feather to its cap. 10 students completed SWAYAM Python programming online course. Ms. Mubina, third BBA, was awarded Mudalvani Virudu by Engineer Perumal Manimekalai College of Engineering, Hosur. Ms. Akshaya of 3rd BSc Biotechnology was awarded Kalpana Chawla Award by JCI Hosur Sipcot. 45 students of Commerce and 32 students of English have presented 49 research papers in international conferences and published their research papers with ISBN. 14 students of Commerce, 340 students of Computer Science, 93 students of English, 121 students of Biotechnology, 26 students of Chemistry, 6 students of Physics participated in the national and international conferences conducted by various colleges. 64 students of English participated in Alliance Literary Fest conducted by Alliance University, Bangalore. The students of management attended implant training and project work in various companies. Ms. Pavitra of 3rd BA English won second prize for Tamil elocution conducted by Tamil Valarchi Kalagam. Ms. Mubina Rani, 3rd BBA, won first prize for business quiz. Ms. Riya, 3rd BBA, won second prize for young manager. Ms. Winifred John Peter Rani, 3rd BBA, won first prize for ADSEP conducted by Engineer Perumal Manimekalai College of Engineering, Hosur. Ms. Delvin JV won second prize in Young Manager, and the students of 2nd BCom CA won second prize in Treasure Hunt in Engineer Perumal Manimekalai College, Hosur. Ms. Kalayarasi from 3rd BSc Chemistry won first place in Drawing and second prize in Face Painting conducted by Helping Stars 2022. Ms. Nivedita of 2nd BSc Chemistry won first prize. Ms. Suveta Christabel of 2nd BA English won second prize. Ms. Kalayarasi of 3rd BSc Biotechnology won third prize in drawing competition celebrating Voters Day. Ms. Prema of 2nd BCom CA won Best Entertainer Award on Instagram by Phoenix Book of World Records. Ms. Ilakia of 2nd BSc Computer Science got first place and won the Best Manager Award and cash prize of Rs. 1000 in RSRA Conference on Recent Trends in Management and Commerce. Ms. Monisha of 3rd BSc Biotechnology won second prize in poster presentation in MGR College, Hosur. The students of Chemistry received second prize in Science Expo held in ERK College, Salem. From the Department of Biotechnology, Ms. Moonshah, Ms. Eswari won first prize in paper presentation. Ms. Ashwini and Ms. Kishonika Sri won second place in paper presentation. Ms. Menaka and Ms. Monisha won third place in paper presentation in a national seminar conducted by Aringarana College, Krishnagiri. Ms. Swati Nakesh won first place in district level online quiz competition conducted by Tamil Nadu AIDS Control Society, Chennai. 87 students of English department participated in Asia Pacific Literary Festival conducted by Alliance University, Bangalore. Ms. Uma Makeshwari and Ms. Aranya of 2nd MSc Computer Science got Best Paper Award in an international conference conducted by RIS Labs, Kaveri Patinam. Memorandum of Understanding. Department of Commerce in association with the EDP Cell signed an MOU with Ekalai Academy, Coimbatore. Department of Commerce signed an MOU with St. Francis de Sales College, Bangalore, and another one with Primax Edu Academy, Bangalore. Department of Business Administration with the Computer Application signed an MOU with National HRD Network, Hosur Chapter, and another one with KPF Tool Tech Private Limited, Hosur. Department of Chemistry signed an MOU with InnoForge Private Limited, Hosur, and with Maitreya Healthcare Private Limited, Hosur. Scholarships. The college supports several economically backward students by providing monetary benefits and helping them to avail scholarships. BC scholarship 76 students, SCST scholarship 148 students, integrated village development program scholarship to 190 beneficiaries amounting rupees 14,57,500. Dr. Marie Louise endowment prize. Dr. Marie Louise has deposited rupees 10 lakh as a scholarship for the poor Catholic students and promised that it would be raised to 25 lakhs. Father Amelin endowment prize. Father Amelin has deposited rupees 50,000 as a scholarship for the poor Catholic students. Pudumai Pen, 244 students amounting rupees 2,44,000. Titan Scholarship, 11 beneficiaries amounting 1,10,000. Sports Quota and Economically Backward Scholarship, 2,17,200. Library. Our library strives to inculcate the interest of learning and research through numerous books and e-resources on all courses. InfliptNet has been registered to enhance the students in the domain of research. To upgrade the reservoir of books, an amount of rupees 2,110,000 was spent on purchasing of books, rupees 15,500 for subscription to journals, and rupees 18,699 for subscription to magazines. The library committee organized Brain Fest, a quiz to all the students. Best practices. Initiation of the academic year with a theme. The theme communion with nature was followed during this academic year, 22-23. All the activities were centered on this theme. Few initiatives are, the competition to design theme logo was introduced, and this logo was designed by Ms. Obalakshmi of 3rd BSc Mathematics. Spacious bird cages were set up during the college atmosphere. Plastic-free campus was the focal point, and the students were motivated to avoid plastic water bottles. Each department has taken a pledge associated with a theme. Saplings were given as a token of remembrance to all the resource persons on various occasions. 35 indoor plants are being maintained by the Department of Biotechnology and Commerce. Medicinal plants were planted by the management. Organic vegetables seeded by the management are utilized by the college staff. The Department of English conducted flash mob communion with nature rally on Save Nature, Save Life, raising awareness through slogans, placards and songs, and a speech on nature on the Founders Day as monthly activities. The Department of Mathematics has adopted star tortoise of Banargatta Zoo for a year. New initiatives during this academic year. Many new committees were structured to benefit the academic, curricular, research excellence of the faculty and students. College has instituted a trust named Samaritan to aid the needy students for their academic support. Launch of new language lab with 60 computer terminals. Registration for educational Google suit. Institutional registrations for academic excellence. College has registered with Institution Innovation Cell, Ministry of Education, Government of India, OSA, Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, Parent Teachers Association, registration of staff profiles in Vidwan database. Towards excellence, Dr. Jennifer, Department of English, and Dr. Sanguvati, Department of Tamil, have submitted proposal to ICSSR on research studies on the culture, history, and geography of the scheduled tribes of India. Management contribution for infrastructural and development and maintenance. Basketball court was constructed at the cost of rupees 15 lakh. For maintenance of the institution, the management has spent 10,69,021 during this academic year. The management has contributed 6,75,350 towards fee for poor students. The language lab was established at the cost of rupees 36,70,500. Extension activities, service to humanity. The extension activities carried out in the college created social consciousness and instills a sense of tolerance, hope and cooperation. A community that is engaged and working together can be a powerful force as it discovers the purpose of existence. Department of Commerce donated sound system and furniture at the cost of 68,000 to students of Government Panchayat Union Primary School, Karisindiram Huzur. Two faculty members of the Department of Commerce conducted banking practices income tax classes for 31 plus 2 students of CSI Christ Matriculation School Huzur and for 100 students of Government Girls High Secondary School Huzur. Department of Computer Science in association with Lions Club took classes about Python and PHP for the 12th students of Government High Secondary School, Zuzuwadi, Huzur. Innovative Entrepreneurship Hands-on Training Program for Chocolate Making and Soap Making was conducted for 150 students at Government High School, Moranapalli. Department of Physics handled classes on light, heat and energy to 30 students of PU School, Arasaneti. Department of Chemistry organized an awareness program on chemicals that induce cancer at Huzur Primary Corporation School, Suzuwadi, an awareness program to the 4th and 5th class students of Government PUB School, Mukundapalli Ozur and National Pollution Control Day Awareness Program for 4th and 5th students, Government PUP School, Mukundapalli Ozur. The Department of Mathematics handled classes to 7th standard students of Government Middle School Arasanetti on exponential divisibility measurement shapes and screened a video on math in real life applications, conducted inter-school competitions for 50 students of Government School Ozur and has adopted taught attires at Banarkata Zoo for a year. Department of Tamil conducted a free value-added course for 30 SC-ST students and various competitions in the honor of APJ Abdul Kalam's birth anniversary. Three faculty members from the Department of English handled English grammar, vocabulary and functional usage for the students of grade 3, 4 and 5 of Government PUP School, Mukundapalli, Kozur. Student Affairs Committee. The Student Affairs Committee contributes to the improvement of the holistic personality development of students related to co-curricular programs. On behalf of 75th Independence Day, interdepartmental competitions like poster making, allocation and poem recitation was conducted by Student Affairs Committee. Women's Day was also celebrated. Sports and games. Playing various sports teach life skills such as teamwork, leadership, accountability, patience, self-confidence and prepares them to face life challenges. Students at our college are motivated with efficient physical directors to balance their physical and mental abilities to achieve goals in their life. Ms. Vidya of 3rd BBA secured first place national volleyball competition conducted in Uttar Pradesh, first place in volleyball match by National Championship Youth Asian Games Federation, Jammu and Kashmir. Volleyball team participated at 70th in Tamil Nadu state level volleyball competition and first place in 17th Junior Volleyball Championship MGR Arts and Science College, Ozur. Ms. Lalita of 3rd Biotechnology and Ms. Varagini of 2nd BCom secured 4th place in table tennis competition at KKC College in Vellore. Ms. Aroki Abisia Delsi of 3rd BCom CA, Ms. Kavita M of SBSC Chemistry and Ms. Nega of SBSC Physics secured 7th, 8th and 12th positions respectively in cross-country race conducted by Periyar University, Salem. Ms. Abhinaya of 3rd BSc, 2nd BSc Computer Science secured 6th place in walk in 36th state level athletic championship in Thiruvannamalai. Volleyball team backed first place in JKK Nadraj College, Erode. 19th Krishnagiri District Athletic Championship 2022. Ms. Shreesha of 2nd BSc Biotechnology and Ms. Kavita of SBSc Chemistry won first place in 3000 meters. Ms. Kavita won second prize in 1500 meters. Ms. Abhinaya of SBSc Computer Science won first place in meters. Ms. Vishali of 3rd BSc Computer Science won first place in high jump and javelin throw. Ms. Chantrika of SBCA won first place in long jump and third in 400 meters. Ms. Abhinaya of the 2nd BCA won first place in 5000 meters walk and was selected for state competition and Olympic training. Ms. Neha of SBSC Physics secured second place in 400 meters and second place in 1500 meters. Ms. Sophia of 2nd BSC Chemistry won third place in high jump. Ms. Pavitra of 2nd BA English and Ms. Teja of 2nd BSC Chemistry won third place in shot put. Ms. Harini of 2nd BSC won third place in 200 meters. Madhumala of 1st BSC Computer Science won third place in 800 meters. Ms. Abhinaya of 2nd BSC won second place in 20 kilometer walk. Ms. Sundari P won third place in discus throw in Periyar University. Intercollegiate athletic competition, Namakkal. Ms. Shakti of 1st BBA and Ms. Navya Shri of 2nd BCom secured 4th place in volleyball in 25th Youth National Championship, Madhya Pradesh. College team won 1st place in volleyball and 2nd place in Kabaddi in Tamil Nadu CM Trophy Games competition. In commemoration of the International Women's Day, Kelo India Sports Development of Tamil Nadu conducted district level women's sports and games competition 2023. Krishnagiri. Aroki Abisaya Delsi won first place in 400 meters in long jump. Sundari won first place on short put. Fauzia won second place in 100 meters and long jump. Chandrika won third place in 200 meters in long jump. College Kabaddi team was the winner and the players are Deepika, Srivarsha, Hamshavartini, Priyanka of 3rd BCom, Lavanya and Chella of 3rd Computer Science, Veena of 2nd Computer Science, Shirisha of 2nd Biotechnology, Nisha of 2nd BA English, Pallavi of 2nd BCom and Ananya of 1st BBA. Youth Red Cross. Young and energetic students, volunteers of our college are trained to create awareness on the care of self-health and that of others to understand and adopt civic responsibilities and act accordingly with humanitarian concern and dedication. Yoga demonstrations were performed by 100 YRC students in the event conducted by Yoga Kalaimamani Sijo M. Aravind, Grand Master, Founder Trustee, ASK Trust, Bangalore. Mr. Saravanan Cyber Branch, Kaliyappan, SI, Mr. Hari Prasad, SI Sipkart, gave awareness on drugs and proper usage of mobile phone. 150 YRC students participated. Mr. Arul, DPM, Collectorate, Krishnagiri, and Ms. Sumati, Consultant, Government Hospital, Huzur, were the chief guests for the YRC orientation program. Community Harmony Day, Anti-Drug Awareness Program, Road Safety Rally, Celebration of National Youth Day with other programs, National Service Scheme. The sole aim of NSS is to provide hands-on experience to young students in the delivering community service. The college volunteers are trained to enhance leadership qualities, fraternity, team spirit, which lead to the improvement of physical and mental strength. The exposure to new vocational possibilities mold them to be better human beings in future. Pledge on plastic-free awareness rally for the campus for Clean and Green India. Cycle rally, awareness on drugs and mobile phone, AIDS, breast cancer, plastic-free, rights and laws of women, anti-drug. National Youth Day, National Voters Day, International AIDS Day, Social Justice Day were celebrated. Red Ribbon Club. The college prepares the youth as peer educators by developing their skills on leadership, communication, negotiation, and team building. On International Youth Day, TNAC online quiz was conducted for 100 RRC students. 200 RRC students participated in online quiz on AIDS, blood donation, tuberculosis, and general knowledge. Institution Innovation Council. This platform helps to find creative aspirants where their innovative ideas and concepts are incubated and realized. The budding entrepreneurs are identified and groomed to become successful in future. They are trained to earn while learning. A workshop on entrepreneurship skill, attitude and behavior development was conducted by the Department of Physics. The Department of Nutrition and Dietetics organized an awareness program on energy conservation. Department of Biotechnology has conducted workshops on herbal soap making, bridal makeup, soft toy making, and organized a field visit to Chandramkudi Lake to study the deterioration of water quality. Department of English, workshop on career counseling. Department of Computer Science conducted an extension activity on innovative entrepreneurship hands-on training program on chocolate making and soup making, a webinar on design thinking as a strategy for innovation. Intellectual property rights cell. The aim of the intellectual property cell is to propagate awareness on the intellectual property among the researchers and staff of the college by organizing workshops, seminars, and training programs. Department of Computer Science, in association with National Intellectual Property Awareness Mission, IQAC, and IPR, CELAFO College conducted a national webinar on intellectual property rights. Srimati Susi K., examiner of Patents and Design, Intellectual Property Office, Chennai, Government of India, was the resource person. Women's Cell. Dr. Mercy Anandaraj, retired Associate Professor of History and former Dean of Student Affairs, Nirmala College for Women, Coimbatore, addressed the students on Women's Day. Women's Cell, in association with the Students Affairs Committee, celebrated International Women's Day. Department of Nutrition and Dietetics conducted pencil sketching on women in 20th century and Tamil elocution on Veeramum Penniyamum. Unnath Bharat Abhiyan. Under Unnath Bharat Abhiyan, the college strives to work with the rural people. Their challenges are identified and solutions are found for their sustainable development. Six villages under Muthukonapalli, S. Panchayat, and Parandur are adopted by the college. Institutional participation registration for these seven villages was completed. A proposal has been sent to conduct NSS activities in these villages. It is decided by the Department of Commerce to donate a projector and a television to the school situated at Muthukonapalli. Entrepreneurship Development Cell. The EDC spreads the significance of entrepreneurship through education, research and training by organizing skill development programs that increase the capacity building of young students to own and run a business. The EDC received a fund of Rs. 10,000 from Periyar University. Dr. Reena Raj and Mrs. Magila attended the review meeting jointly organized by Periyar University IEDP Hub and EDIL and received appreciation certificate for the same. Department of Commerce and EDC organized two workshops on ways to combat challenges and women entrepreneurs skill development program And one day, hands-on workshop on paperback making, candle and keychain making were taught by the Department of Mathematics in association with EDC. Department of Management in association with EDC conducted one-day workshop on my life, my business. And two students from management attended e-leader workshop conducted by Periyar University. Department of Biotechnology along with IAS and EDC conducted a motivation session and hands-on training on herbal soap making. The EDC in association with the Departments of Computer Science, Mathematics and Commerce conducted one-day workshop on Institution Innovation Council, Business Plan Preparation, Design Thinking and Intellectual Property Rights. Department of Nutrition and Dietetics in association with EDC conducted a workshop on food preservation techniques. A two-day workshop on tassel tangling and stud making was conducted by the Department of Physics in association with IAS and EDC. Department of Chemistry organized a workshop on phenyl making. Department of English on career counseling. RSP, the primary purpose of this community is to enhance the safety of students, promoting the development of leadership skills and good citizenship qualities. They are regularly trained through orientation program, creating awareness on road safety rules and responsibilities of RSP candidates. 35 candidates participated in Republic Day Parade in Krishnagiri and was appreciated by the district collector. Placement cell. The placement cell of a college has always played a pivot role in the job opportunities to the students. The placement cell focused on programs like career guidance, career and placement orientation, Berkeley's life skills program, placement training, entrepreneurship skill, attitude and behavior development. Mega job fair was conducted on 19th May 2022 in our college campus. 246 students were placed in Tetra Race, One Mark Solutions, VK New Phytotech, Tangis Technologies, VIP Info Connect, Sarathi Germinate Nidhi Limited, MS Dhoni School, Titan School and Teal. Students were placed in positions in medical coding and medical billing with Indian Healthcare BBO. Consumer Club. The Consumer Club has been working on creating and spreading awareness on consumer rights amongst all students. World Consumer Rights Day was celebrated. Catechism and Moral Philosophy. Catechism and Moral Philosophy classes are held every Wednesday to impart righteous values to the young minds, which will enable them to become good citizens, morally upright, socially sensitive and spiritually oriented. Victoria SFS BCA won prize in 1 minute video making and drawing competition organized by Social Interaction Team Presentation Congregation Coimbatore. Each department assigns faculty to be mentors for each class and provide counseling whenever in need and guide and mold them to be good students. Parent Teachers Association. Parent Teachers Meeting is a remarkable aspect of the college encouraging beneficial association between parents and teachers. The academic and personal interactions have formed better understanding of the needs and the background of the students. Our college holds parent-teacher meetings on a regular basis. Old Students Association. The OSA provides opportunities for the alumni of our college to connect with their alma mater. The Old Students Association of our college conducted a trade fair and earned ₹30,001. Movie Club. The Movie Club inculcates a sense of watching films collectively among students with an efficient and effective screening process. Encanto, Oscar-winning animated feature film, was shown in the odd semester. General features. Being a part of the harmonized society is an important feature of the college experience. Celebration and significant occasions provide a great opportunity for students to connect with others who share their interests and create a sense of community. The following programs were held from May 22 to March 23. Valedictory function, farewell for the final year students, reopening of the college with Eucharistic celebration, Students Union inaugural 75th Independence Day, Freshers Day, Teachers Day, Fine Arts inaugural and valedictory, launch of 5G technology by Central Government of India, Christmas celebration, Pongal by each department, the management visit, Sports Day and Women's Day. Office management. It is my privilege to recognize the indispensable services of our college staff. The office with its competent, meticulous and determined non-teaching staff are the source of completing all the documentation of official communications, disbursement and proper handling of finance, creating and maintenance of student faculty records and academic communication on time without any interruption in the functioning of the institution. Their infallible work and accommodative efforts have paved way for the smooth operations of the institution with the government, RJD office, Periyar University and UGC. I commend and applaud all the non-teaching staff in the office. Green initiatives. To bring back the richness of the mother soil, measures are taken to follow sustainability, maintaining the green wealth in the campus and creating awareness among the youngsters on the importance of creating, maintaining an eco-friendly environment everywhere. Some of our effective green moves to lower the impact of environmental hazards include campus reconstruction in accordance with the sustainability principles and methods, installation of solar panels, water conservation practices, passive LED lighting, complete ban on use of plastics, use of effective eco-friendly products like paper bags. I would like to recognize the work of all the non-teaching staff of our college, with whose hard work and persistent support we have been maintaining a green and clean St. Joseph campus. Gratitude is a powerful catalyst for happiness. It is the spark that lights a fire of joy in your soul. I may call it. It gives me immense pleasure to thank Very Reverend Mother Fabi Linnett, who took up the reins of the presentation congregation as the Superior General and President of the Governing Body of our institution. I sincerely thank the Provincial Sister Alvin for all the support and guidance for the growth of the college. I record my thanks to Dr. Anthony Louis Periyakumar Douglas for his gracious presence. I express my gratitude to heads of the departments, coordinators of all committees, academic faculty, supportive staff, the sisters of the community and the neighboring communities, students' union and the student community, alumni, parents, benefactors, well-wishers, stakeholders for all the thoughtful and kind cooperation for the growth of the college. Pope Francis says, it needs educators capable of developing an ethics of ecology and helping people through effective pedagogy to grow in solidarity, responsibility. May the light of education be spread in every thought, word, and action of St. Joseph fraternity in the years to come. May the good Lord mold every one of us in cultivating the humblest version committed to ourselves as well as others. Thank you and God bless you.
Thank you, sister. A person's greatest emotional need is to feel appreciated, says Brown. Now it is a time for appreciating the efforts of the students by giving them prizes for all of their achievements. Here are our Josephites queued up to receive the rewards.
Now, I request Mrs. Vadivu, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, and Mrs. Shobhna Priya, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, to call out the prize winners.
Good evening to all. I would request our esteemed chief guest, Dr. Anthony Louis Priyakumar Douglas, Dean of Cambridge College of Technology, Bengaluru, to felicitate General Proficiency Prize for the achievers. From 1st BA English, 1st place, Ovia S. 2nd place, Ranjita M. 2nd BA English, 1st place, Harini. 2nd place, Danushya. 3rd BA English, 1st place, Manasa. 2nd place, Bhavya. 1st MA English, 1st place, Almas. 2nd place, Mahashweta. 2nd MA English, 1st place, Nivedita. 2nd place, Kritika. 1st BBACA, 1st place, Salima Begum. 2nd place, Safinas. from second BBA CA, first place Chaitra V, second place Chaitra B. From third BBA CA, first place Gayatri R, second place Trisha. From first BCA, first place Achana, second place Swastika. From second BCA, first place Nazia, second place Hivziya Taskin. From third BCA, first place Aruna, second place Nityashree. From first BCOM A, first place Kalaichelvi, second place Monisha. From first BCOM B, first place Sai Sahana, second place Priyadashni. From second BCOM A, first place Devidashni, second place Dhanam. From second BCOM B, first place Roshini, second place Maulya. From third BCOM A, first place Jyoti, second place Kavyanjali. From third BCOM B, first place Vishnuvarshini, second place Varsha. From first BCOM CAA, first place Lalita, second place Meghna. From first CAB, first place Anjini, second place Soundarya. From second BCOM CAA, first place Akshita, second place Jayanti. From second CAB, first place Tejashwini, second place Sushmita. From third BCOM CAA, first place Divyashri, second place Jamuna. From third BCOM CAB,
first place Ashoka, second place Supriya. From first BCOM, first place Gayatri, second
place Devi Priya. From second MCOM, first place Archana, second place Shalini. From first BSc Biotech, first place Anusha, second place Meenakshi. From second BSc Biotech, first place Manjupriya, second place Fidosia. From third BSc Biotech, first prize Chaitra V, second place Akshaya. From first BSc Chemistry, first place Rajashree, second place Venmati. From second BSc Chemistry, first place Monica, second place Reena Roshni. From third BSc Chemistry, first place Reena Shri, second place Kiran. From first BSc CS, first place Vigneshwari, second place shared by Reshmika and Divya Dashni. From second BSc CS, first place Ilakya, second place Deepana. From third BSc CS, first place Asofia Shan, second place Harshita. From second MSc CS, first place Kalpana, second place Archana.
From first BSc Max, first place Shaisha Siddhika, second place Ashwini. From second BSc Max, first place Kanakatara, second place Tavanidhi. From third BSc Max, first place Swati, second place shared by Anjali and Shanmugapriya. First MSc Max, first place Nivetita, second place Evangeline Maria. Second MSc Max, first place Subiksha, second place Deepa. From first BSc Nutrition and Dietetics, first place Angel Nisha, second place Arnold Solima. From second BSc Nutrition and Dietetics, first place Bhavani, second place Brinda. From third BSc Nutrition and Dietetics, first place Adia Arbin, second place Aklin Jovita. From first BSc Physics, first place Aksha Anjum, second place Pavitra. From second BSc Physics, first place Amrita Varshini, second place Akshya. Third BSc Physics, first place Evangeline, second place Kritika. Congratulations to all of you students. Thank you, sir. Now I request our Honorable Secretary, Reverend Sister Mary Lucy Juliet, to distribute the awards. Language proficiency, first years in Tamil, first place shared by Manju Priya S of first BSc Max, Venmati S of first BCA. Second place shared by Danshri P of first BSc Biotechnology and Venmati A of first BSc Chemistry. In French, first place Aaron Salomi LS of first BSc Nutrition and Dietetics. In Hindi, first place Shazia Siddhika Y of first BSc Mathematics. In Kannada, first place Anisha M of first BSc Nutrition and Dietetics, second place Rakshita S of first BCom CA. In Telugu, first place Sandhya A of first BBA CA. In English, first place shared by Priyadashni A of first BCom and Bhavyashri N of first BA English. Second place shared by Anisha R of first BSc Biotechnology and Ramya Shri M of first BSc Computer Science. Second years in Tamil, first place shared by Monisha P of second BSc Biotechnology and Ruchita A of second BSc Biotechnology. Second place Nasya M of second BCA. In French, first place Madhupriya J of second BCA, second place Jitana JS of second BSc Computer Science. In Hindi, first place Asia Sultana M of 2nd BSc Nutrition and Dietetics. 2nd place, Veena H of 2nd BSc Computer Science. In Kannada, 1st place, Nishchita TK of 2nd BCA. 2nd place, Fatima Zora S of 2nd BSc Mathematics. In Telugu, 1st place, Gunashree S of 2nd BCA, A of 2nd BSc Biotechnology. In English, 1st place, Sabatina Mary Faustina P of 2nd BA English. 2nd place, Priyadashni V of 2nd BCA. I'm really glad to call upon our centum scorers, Dhanam V of 2nd BCom in Corporate Accounting 1. Tejashwini D, Tarani L, Vishnupriya C, Shushmita A of 2nd BCom CA in Business Mathematics and Statistics. Mamta Shri K of 3rd BCom CA in Cost Accounting. Shanmugapriya P of 3rd BSc Mathematics got centum in Trigonometry 2D and 3D and SBEC Quantitative Aptitude. Shaila Maglin J of 3rd BSc Max in Quantitative Aptitude. Santoshi MP of 3rd BSc Max in Quantitative Aptitude. Thank you, sister, for honoring the winners. It is time to honor our outstanding students who have achieved both in academics and in extracurricular activities. Now, I am pleased to welcome our respected principal, Reverend Sister Dr. Helen, to distribute the certificates and memento to the Manasa achievers. Manasa Y of 3rd BBA CA, Sushma M of 3rd BCA, Varsha G of 3rd BCom, Ashoda N of 3rd BCom CA, Kishonika Shri JV of 3rd BSc Biotechnology, Akshaya R of 3rd BSc Chemistry, Sunanda M of 3rd BSc Computer Science, Arifa A of 3rd BSc Mathematics, Kavyamala S of 3rd BSc Nutrition and Dietetics, Evangeline K of 3rd BSc Physics. I am proud to call upon our college Jubal Choir, who make every event a mesmerizing memory with their beautiful singing. I invite Jaya Vinoda J.S. of 2nd BSc Computer Science, head girl of our college choir, to receive the appreciation. A responsible, sincere, and dedication in administrating the college on students' behalf. Our college union, who have contributed their sincere efforts in organizing every event. I gladly invite the college union president, Swati M. of 3rd BSc Mathematics, to receive the appreciation and honor on behalf of the union. Our college band with well-disciplined, talented musicians who have truly rendered their remarkable contribution on every occasion and make it special and auspicious. I call upon the college band leader Divya A of 2nd BCA to receive the honor and appreciation on behalf of the band. Our safety team's contribution to our college and to our society is truly astounding. I call upon Kritika VP of 2nd BCA to receive the honor and appreciation on students' behalf. The endowment recipients are Pavitra S. of 3rd BA English, Jennifer E. of 2nd MA English, Monica K. of 3rd BBA CA, Nityashree R. of 3rd BCA, Jyoti T. of 3rd BCOM A, Suganya 3rd BCOM B, Manusha N. of 3rd BCOM CA B, Devi Darshini of 2nd MCOM, Ramya SP of 3rd BSc Biotechnology, Ruchita M of 3rd BSc Chemistry, Annie Belsita S of 3rd BSc Computer Science, Angalishwari T of 2nd MSc Computer Science, Soundarya V of 2nd MSc Mathematics, Akshaya Reddy R of 3rd BSc Nutrition and Dietetics, Steffi Rose L of 3rd BSc Physics. Thank you, dear sister. A participant is already a winner. We as a mentor motivate our students to participate in many events to explore and to exhibit their talent and skills. We once again congratulate all the winners who have honored their efforts of their parents and teachers. Thank you.
Congratulations to all the talented stars of Josephite family. To be inspired is great, but to be an inspiration is an honor. It is our great honor to have our honorable chief guest, Dr. Anthony Louis Priyakumar Douglas, Dean, Cambridge College of Technology, Bangalore, who is a man of distinct vision and a founding head of illuminating ideas, an idol of knowledge and experience, an inspiration to all of us amidst us today. Now, I cordially invite our distinguished chief guest to decorate the podium with his presence and to enlighten us with his valuable thoughts.
Thanks to our Sister General. Thank you for your August presence, Sister. Thank you, Sister Principal, Sister. Thank you for the invitation. It was very kind of you. And thank you, Sister Valen, and all the sisters there. And you are doing a very wonderful job. Thank you so much. And I am impressed with all of you for one single reason, that you are so silent when somebody was speaking. Real hats off to you. Real hats off to you. Real hats off to you. I remember my college days, we were very noisy. Boys are always like that, so, but forget about that one. Sister has asked me to talk some few things about what is meant by communion with the nature. This is a very fantastic topic you have taken as a theme. In fact, Pope Francis, when he became the Pope, he took the name Francis because the Francis of Assisi was so close to the environment. He liked that thing. That is why he took the name as Francis. It's not Francis Xavier, Francis Assisi, who was also close to the nature. So I just want to talk. I will not speak much. I don't like speaking much. I will speak very few words only. But I want you to think, because I too have two daughters. I don't have sons. I have two daughters. So one is studying fourth year MBBS. Another is doing law in Bangalore. I come from Bangalore. But what is the most important thing as a human being? We are all human beings. Whether we are following one religion or the other religion, we are from one state or speak some language, it doesn't matter at all. What matters is only one thing. Always, as Jesus said, love thy neighbor. There is nothing more, even love God, that's also the first commandment. But the most important commandment is love thy neighbor. one of the things what many times we forget is that the thou thy neighbor is only for human beings. We don't extend it to the nature. Please try to extend it to the nature. If you could extend it to the nature, it will be really, really wonderful. You are taking lot of steps. I do understand. Sister has banned lot of plastics into the campus. So many things, saplings they are giving it. But think it in the other way. How much we are polluting. Polluting the atmosphere, polluting the water in the name of industrialization. So many things we are doing. But sometimes that may be required. May be required. For example, every car pollutes, every bus pollutes. But can we stop that? We cannot stop that. But we can think of alternate technologies like EV, electrical vehicles. So think about us. You are graduating, I think probably in one semester, next semester, they will be graduating. Just think about one thing, what you can do. What you can do with your education. Sisters have given you a very nice education. So try to see one thing. We are not saying change the whole world tomorrow morning. No. What that you can, as an individual, contribute to this. It gave me a very smallest thing. Maybe I stop the, I close the faucet when I am brushing. Very simple thing. I save some water. Or I switch off. No need of such a bright lights. I switch them off. I save electricity. Think about what are the small, small things what you can do. That is more than sufficient. Much more than sufficient. As women, I thought I should speak about women at least one thing. Yes, we have a lot of troubles. We do understand. I'm very happy some of the police officials have come. Thank you for that. Thanks for coming. It is wonderful that you are supporting women. That's very, very important. In fact, I come from a police officer's family. My grandfather was a police officer. My father was an assistant commissioner. Now my brother is an assistant commissioner in Chennai. So I come from that thing. I know what the trouble they go through. It is not that easy to be a police officer. It is very tough, a daunting task. It requires a lot of courage to stand up and speak the truth. In their department, doing that is very, very tough. Lot of women are coming. Lot of women police officers are there. That's very good. But what I want to tell one thing, I always believe in sending one message. Always that goes in, that's enough, rather than speaking a list of it. One thing, the one thing is that the rock. I'm sure all of you have seen the rock, right? The rock, even if you try to take a huge iron bar and try to hit it, it will take time to break. But the very same rock, if you plant something, some plants, the tender roots can easily penetrate through this thing. In Tamil, I think, I know some of the Tamil professors are there. I think it is Nallanai Nangu. Pasumarathu aanikku nekku vidum paare. That rock itself, the poet says, it gives way only for the root of the small plant, not for the iron rod. Not for the iron rod. Women should be like that. You should be firm, that is required. At the same time, you should be also kind. This is something you should think. When you should be firm, and then you should be kind. If you could find that thing, decipher it, I am sure you will be a successful person. I see lot of prize winners. I was feeling very happy. So lot of things you could do. As I told you, decide upon one thing. This I will do. If you could do this, I am sure this country, not necessarily this college alone, our country will be in a far better place. Far better place. When I went to Germany for my PhD, the women were considered on par with men. There was no way the women were in any form were made little lesser. No way. They were having all the freedom. Like Gandhiji rightly said, I will not accept the political freedom what we have because I will accept. Gandhiji said, it's not me. The father of the nation said, if a woman can walk at the midnight wearing all gold and returns back safely, then alone we have the freedom. That's the most important freedom that what we need. And I strongly believe just the police forces cannot make it happen, but you can make it happen. If you are very firm and you stand for your virtues, if women stand for the virtues, lot many things can be done. Lot many things can be done. For that, you should try to learn from the nature. Nature teaches us lots of things. We call our Hindu brethren, call them as panchaputs. They say there are five big elements, something like, they call them as Bhuma Devi. Why do we call that as a Bhuma Devi in a feminine form? There is a meaning there. Thiruvalluvar says, Ahalvarai Thangum Nihalam Pole, Tammai Ihalvar Puruttal Thalai. Not only for women, for men also. The world will criticize us. Every time they will criticize us. Whether you do good, bad, ugly, they will criticize. But don't worry too much about this. Take it as a compliment. Try to work on it every time. Nobody is perfect. I'm not perfect. I don't know anybody else is perfect here. Everybody makes mistakes. That is the natural thing for us to do as human beings. But what you can learn from is from the criticism. You can say, oh, maybe I made a mistake. Try to refine myself. That's one thing what you can learn. Being very patient like the mother earth. You plow this thing, you misuse it, but still it's very quiet, calm, nice. It doesn't revolt or do anything. That's one thing you can learn from the mother earth, from the water. That is the second thing they call this, one of the major elements. We can be without air is very tougher. I mean, it's a tougher thing. But water, one of the basic characteristics of water is it is neither colorless, it is neither odorless. It is odorless and colorless. It is neither colorful nor odorful. You can be like, you need not to be very handsome or beautiful or most intelligent. Nothing is required like that to be successful in life. What is required to be successful in life is adaptability. That's what the most important thing. The water, you put it in any form, it takes that form. Adaptability is the most important thing. If you could adapt, if you could learn from that nature, especially from the water, how it adapts. It doesn't have any color, it doesn't have any water, but still, it is a very important element. So learn from this. That's the most important thing. Third element is fire. Fire consumes everything. Fire doesn't care whether you are a professor or whether you have a PhD in topology. Doesn't care. It consumes everyone. Equal treatment. The learning that you can take from fire is equal treatment. Try to treat people, whether they are higher than you, lower than you, whether they are influential, doesn't matter. Treat every human being equally. This is very, very important, because that should be our nature. The people will look at you and say, oh, these are all from St. Joseph's College. How can they say, looking at your nature and behavior? If you could behave considering every person equal, that will be very fantastic. The fourth element is air. Without air, we cannot sustain for a long time. The life depends upon the air, and you should be that life to many people, not necessarily to only to your families, not necessarily only to your college, for the whole society. In fact, the whole humanity. There are people who have contributed a lot. If you look into Marie Curie, the first woman who got the Nobel Prize, she got twice, by the way. She got twice. Her works are still continued. She never thought she's a woman. In those days, only men alone used to get Nobel Prize. She was the first lady to get the Nobel Prize. But her works are still continued. You can also do that. You can be a life to many people. Many people. Finally, the last panchaput is called Akash. the atmosphere or space. In fact, there is one line called Karman line. I don't know how many of you know that. Kake line, that is the one which differentiates between the atmosphere and space. When you can say that you have gone to the spaces, you have to cross that Karman line. That Karman line is 100 kilometers from the mean sea level. Let's not worry too much about this. The key point is the space is always expanding. Space is always expanding. You need to grow. This is very, very important. Being pious is okay. Being good is okay. Everything is okay. Righteous is okay. But you need growth. If you cannot grow, that is not the natural thing. Find ways to grow. Grow does not mean growing in size, but growing in doing service to others. You need to be a resourceful person. People should come to you whenever they have some problem. They should think of a neighbor like you. Oh, this person can help me out. Maybe you can help them in the assignment, or maybe you can help them in their examinations. Maybe you can help them when they are not well. So many things you can do. Learn from the nature. The nature communicates in a very silent way. The messages, the natures are very silent. If you could understand, you will react. You will react in the best possible way. And I am sure you will come up. Maybe some other time when I come next time, I would like to see many people coming and telling here, this is what I have done. I am very happy. Many people are getting this prize, that prize, in academics, in sports, very good. But also put some goals. This is what I have done to my society. Let's next time see how many people have done what to the society. God bless you.
Thank you, sir, for your motivating and thought-provoking words. Many feelings may come and go, but that feeling when we hear our college anthem raises our goosebumps is irreplaceably magical. Now, let us invite our Jubal Choir to sing our college anthem.
Joseph, a patron, a martyr, we hail and glorify thee. Just and true were you in life, simple and humble were you in heart. Joseph, a patron, a martyr, we hail. Joseph, a patron, a martyr,
Thank you, choir. I request everyone to be seated. No duty is more urgent than that of returning thanks. Now, I call upon Dr. Deena Suresh, Head and Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, to render the acknowledgements.
I will give thanks to the Lord because of His righteousness. I will sing the praises of the name of the Lord Most High. Psalm 7:17. A very warm good evening to all the wonderful people present here. On behalf of the management, principal, faculty and students of St. Joseph's College of Arts and Science for Women, Hosur, I feel honored to propose the oath of thanks on this remarkable 15th college day of our college. I thank the Lord Almighty who has designed and refreshed our souls with sweet stream of blessings. His unfailing love keeps us march forward towards better tomorrow with confidence and strength. Gratitude is a positive emotion that involves being thankful and appreciative. First and foremost, I extend my profound gratitude to our secretary, Reverend Sister Mary Lucy Juliet, for her phenomenal guidance and words of wisdom in all the endeavors. Thank you for your presence today, Sister. I would like to spell out my heartfelt gratitude to our beloved principal, Reverend Sister Dr. M. Helen, who is always determined to achieve the best in all the activities in our college. We are grateful to have such an eminent administrator and a woman of conviction. Thank you, Sister, for adorning the occasion. Being thankful and expressing your gratitude is an important part of being happy in life. I would like to take this opportunity to place on record our hearty thanks to our chief guest, Dr. D. Anthony Lewis Priyakumar, R&D Dean, Cambridge Institute of Technology, Bangalore, for his august presence today. Dear sir, your speech has enlightened us with great knowledge. Thank you for encouraging us with your powerful words of wisdom, sir. We are indeed privileged to have you among us today. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invite and for gracing the event. We all are inspired by your great words. Thank you, sir. Next, I would like to thank Reverend Father Adi Rubin, Parish Priest, St. Luke's Church, Hosur, for his valuable presence, prayers, and support in everything we do. Thank you, Father. I must mention a deep sense of appreciation to all the sisters from St. Joseph's Metric High Secondary School, Hosur, and St. Joseph's Academy, Hosur. Dear sisters, your presence today has cherished and motivated all our minds to work together with commitment and enthusiasm. Thank you, sisters. I shower my deep sense of gratitude to the Reverend Fathers and Reverend Sisters of various other congregations for gracing this occasion today. Your thoughts enlightened our minds and shown us new path. Thank you, dear Fathers and Sisters. I thank all the members of the Department of Police for training our RSP and make us walk with pride. Thank you, officers. Feeling thankfulness and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. We are highly grateful to all the parents and well-wishers who are the rock-solid support system and encouragement. Our sincere gratitude goes to all the parents for taking part in this event with great enthusiasm. Thank you, dear parents. An event like this cannot happen overnight. It requires planning and a bird's eye for details. I would like to mention a special thanks to all the staff and students of the Fine Arts Committee for giving their best in making this event a huge success. I'm short of words for their involvement and their willingness to take on the completion of tasks before their comfort zones. I thank a Jubal Choir team who makes us feel the presence of the Lord Almighty every time they sing. I also thank a college band for bringing us in the sense of dignity and pride. Thank you, choir and band. An event like this can happen only if it is backed by people who work tirelessly for making it a great success. A special thanks to all the heads of the department, coordinators, and faculty members of each committee for their untiring and earnest effort, which has made this day a grand success. The essence of fruit is always tasted at the last, and we believe last will be the best forever. This event would not have been a great success without the support of the union members, organizing secretaries, and the volunteers of this college day, who were the driving force behind this event. Our students who are going to give incredible performances are worthy of appreciation from our college. I would also like to thank our technical team and service providers of light, sound, photography, advertising, transport, and catering. Thank you all for your unwavering support. I'm very much thankful to all the supporting staff members who stood by our side and took great efforts to organize this college day. Gratitude is a fairest blossom which springs from the soul. I would like to extend my deep sense of gratitude to all the known and unknown hands that contributed to the success of our college. I once again thank everyone whose contribution has made this college day a successful event. Thank you all.
Thank you, madam. The stage is not merely the meeting place of all the arts, but is also the return of art to life. Now we are about to witness some phenomenal talent and handful of various programs to keep you thrilled and entertained. So let us put our hands together for the charming start of the show.
Her hair, the open sky, and her body, the ground that we walk upon. Time is ticking away. As we exploit this gentle source of life to build our lives, our comforts, our luxuries, we have ignored her call. Time is ticking away. It's time to reinvigorate and celebrate this mother that has birthed us, fed us, and one who will embrace us into her bosom in our death. Ho, mother, in celebration of your grandeur, in concern for your well-being, in love with all that you are, we dance in tune to your rhythm as we are just a part of you.
Yeah. சரிமா. என்னடி தங்கம் தொங்குறி அடிச்செல்லாம்.
நம்மை கவனமாய் காத்துக் கொள்கிறாள். உண்ண உணவும் காற்றும் புகலிடமும் தருகிறாள். நாம் செய்யும் அத்தனை கொடுமைகளையும் பொறுத்துக் கொள்கிறாள். இவ்வளவு பெருமை மிகுந்த இயற்கை அன்னையை நாம் மறுத்து மகிழ்விக்க வேண்டாமா?
வெண்ணிலாவின் ஒளி வியக்கத்தக்கது, மண்ணின் வாசம் மயக்கத்தக்கது, மேகத்தின் மழை துளி வினோதமானது, பூக்களின் நறுமணம் புதுமையானது, பறவைகளின் பாட்டு இனிமையானது, மரத்தின் தென்றல் மென்மையானது, ஆழ்கடல் அமைதி அதிசயமானது, அருவியின் அழகு ஆச்சரியமானது, விண்ணின் தூரம் விசாலமானது. இவை அனைத்தையும் உண்டாக்கிய இயற்கை புதிரானது மட்டுமல்ல, புனிதமானதும் கூட. எத்தனை யுகம் கடந்தாலும் அழியா வரம் பெற்ற இறைவனின் அற்புத படைப்பு இயற்கை. இயற்கையின் உறவினை நேசிப்போம்.
ஷேக்ஸ்பியர் சேஸ், ஒன் டச் ஆஃப் நேச்சர் மேக்ஸ் த ஹோல் வேர்ல்ட் கின். பேர்ட்ஸ் சிங் வித்தவுட் எனி எக்ஸ்பெக்டேஷன் ஆஃப் ஆடியன்ஸ். ஃப்ளவர்ஸ் ஈல்ட் ஃப்ராக்னன்ஸ் பட் நெவர் டிமாண்ட் காப்பிரைட் ஃபார் இட். த சன் கிவ்ஸ் அவுட் இட்ஸ் வேல்யூபிள் ரேஸ் பட் இஸ் நெவர் பார்ஷியல் லைக் ஹியூமன் பீயிங்ஸ். லெட்ஸ் டேஸ்ட் அண்ட் ஃபீல் த குட்னஸ் ஆஃப் நேச்சர் அரவுண்ட் அஸ்.
எங்க போற?
நானா? பெரிய பெரிய காடு தாண்டி, கடலை தாண்டி, மலையெல்லாம் தாண்டி தூரமா போறேன்.
அம்மா, இன்னைக்கு எங்க பள்ளி ஆசிரியை நிலாசோறு சாப்பிட்ட தன்னோட ஞாபகங்களை சொன்னாங்க. அதை கேட்ட உடனே எனக்கும் நிலாசோறு சாப்பிடணும் போல ஆசையா இருக்குமா.
அப்படியா? சரி சரி, வீட்டுக்குள்ள ஒரே வெட்கையா இருக்குது. வா, நம்ம மாடிக்கு போய் நிலா வெளிச்சத்துல சாப்பிட்டுட்டு காத்தோட்டமா இருந்துட்டு வரலாம்.
சரிங்க அம்மா, நீங்க நிலாசோறு சாப்பிட்ருக்கீங்களா?
அந்த காலத்துல கரண்ட் இல்லைனா கூட விசிறியோ மெழுகுவர்த்தியோ தேவைப்படாது. நிலா வெளிச்சத்துல சாப்பிட்டுட்டு வீசுற காத்துக்கு அப்படியே தூங்கிடுவோம். ஆனா இப்போ கொஞ்ச நேரம் கூட ஃபேன் இல்லாம இருக்க முடியல.
இந்த நிலைமைக்கு என்ன காரணம் அம்மா?
நாம தான் காரணம். வீட்டை சுத்தி மரம் இருக்கிறதுக்கு பதிலா இப்ப எங்க பார்த்தாலும் வெறும் கட்டிடமா தான் இருக்கு.
ஆமாங்க அம்மா, நீங்க சொல்ற மாதிரி ஒரு காலத்துல இங்க பார்த்தாலும் பச்சை பசல்னு இருந்த இந்த உலகம் இன்னைக்கு வெறும் கட்டிடமா தான் காட்சி அளிக்குது.
Oh. Soundarya, oh, you're here. We must be ashamed to be marine researchers.
The rails under the ocean give more oxygen than the trees inland. How many people know this fact? I wonder.
True. Very few know the fact. I am worried about how the ocean is being turned into a big ditch in the recent years.
Yes. All the factory waste and effluents have been dumped into the ocean. Ships spill tons and tons of oil and sewage into the ocean water. The polluted river water gets mixed into it. Plastics and e-waste have been thrown into the ocean, making it into an enormous garbage tank. Millions of living organisms living in the ocean are immensely affected. Dolphins die on the shore, countless fish die and float on the water surface. Even consuming seafood is leading to a lot of skin diseases and allergies. Plastic waste thrown into the sea entangles many sea creatures, choking them until death. What is to be done to save the ocean and the living beings depending on it?
I am burdened by that fact too. Awareness should be given to people first. Then only change can happen.
Yes, I'm creating awareness about how we are endangering the lives of sea creatures and thereby causing natural calamities is the only solution.
People should change their ways and stop destroying nature.
Yes.
Feeling scared to know all these things.
Do not be scared. You sleep well.
With every drop of water we drink, every breath we take, we are connected to the sea, no matter where we live, says Dr. Sylvia Earle.
Takes my life, never gonna get me out of life. I will live a thousand million lives.
My patience is waning. Is this entertaining? My patience is waning. Is this entertaining?
I got this feeling, yeah, you know, where I'm losing all control. Cause there's magic in my bones. I got this feeling in my soul. Go ahead and throw your stuff.
I can see you.
graves are not just art for Michelangelo to carve. He can rewrite the egg rule of my fury heart. I'm way on mountaintops in Paris going to Bavaria.
Faiza, what are you doing?
Studying English, Mama.
Sleep soon. It's already 9:30 p.m.
Okay, Mama.
Faiza, her brother Feroz, father and mother are sleeping. Earthquake happens at 4:17 a.m. on 6/2/2023 with 7.8 magnitude. Bodies of Feroz and his father are missing. Mother cries, holding the hands of her daughter Faiza. In the camp for the rescued people, Indian rescue team gives water and food to the people, including the mother.
Please do not cry. I understand your pain.
Thank you. If only we had respected and taken care of Mother Nature, this earthquake wouldn't have happened, and my family would have been alive.
The rescue team is called to the neighboring state as the people suffer there due to flood.
மனிதநேயம் மறந்த கதையாகிவிட்டது. மதம் நிலை பெற்றாகிவிட்டது. ஒரு பாதி கற்பூரத்தி, மறு பாதி மெழுகுவத்தி, இவன் பாதி ஊதுபத்தி என பிரிந்த நெஞ்சங்கள் ஒன்றுபட்ட மனிதனேய கதை இது. நம்முடைய மக்களுக்கும் இளைஞர்கள் தங்கள் உதவி கரங்களை நீட்டி திரும்பி வா என்று நம்பிக்கை அளித்தனர். மறந்த கதையாகிவிட்டன. மனித நேயம் நிலை பெற்றாகிவிட்டது. பிரிந்து நின்ற உள்ளங்கள் கரம் போர்த்த நாளது. மனிதனை மனிதன் என காட்ட மட்டுமுள்ள ஒரு வழி இதுவே. மனித நேயம் தொலையும் முன் தேடுங்கள்.
மனிதம் ஒன்றே தீர்வாகும். உயிர்கள் எழுந்தது போதும், உறவுகள் அழுந்தது போதும், அன்பே என்றும் தீர்வாகும்.
இனிமையானது, மகிழ்வானது இயற்கை உயிர்களின் கருவறை. அது மாபெரும் பிரம்மம், உயிர்களின் ஆதாரமும் வாழ்வாதாரமும் இயற்கையே.
பாட்டி,
பாட்டி எங்க இருக்கீங்க?
வாடா என்றா சாத்தி, ஸ்கூல் லீவா?
ஆமாம் பாட்டி, இந்த வெயில்ல இங்க என்ன பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கீங்க?
செடி வச்சிட்டு இருக்கேம்மா.
ஐயோ பாட்டி, உங்களுக்கே வயசாயிடுச்சு. இந்த மரக்கன்று எப்போ வளர்ந்து மரமாகி பழம் தருது? இப்போது உங்களுக்கு பயனில்லைன்னு தெரிஞ்சோம், நீங்க ஏன் உங்க உடம்பை இந்த வெயில வருத்திக்கிறீங்க?
ராசாத்தி, நம்ம தோட்டத்தில் இருக்கிற மரமும் பழமும் நம் முன்னோர்கள் வைத்தது தான். நம் சந்ததிக்கு நாம் தானே நட்டு வைக்கணும். ஒரு நாள் நாம இருக்க மாட்டோம், ஆனா நம்ம நட்ட மரங்கள் பயனளிக்கும் தானே?
ஆமாம் பாட்டி, நீங்க சொல்றது உண்மைதான். நானும் உங்களுக்கு உதவுறேன்.
நாம் ஒவ்வொருவரும் இயற்கையே. இயற்கையோடு தொடர்பு கொள்ளும் போது நாம் ஆற்றல் பெறுகிறோம். இயற்கையோடு இயைந்து வாழ்பவருக்கு இயற்கையானது அறிவாகவோ ஆற்றலாகவோ செல்வமாகவோ தன்னை வாரி வழங்குகிறது.
Thank you. चमक चमक देखो बिजली
मन धड़काए बदरवा मन धड़काए बदरवा
मन मन धड़काए बदरवा
काले मेघा पानी तो बरसाओ बिजली की तलवार नहीं बूंदों के बाण चलाओ
मेघा छाए बरखा लाए
गिर गिर आए गिर के आए
बदल तू घर से निकल
बरसने वाला टिक
कसम ये खाए रे टिक 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 प्लास्टिक टिक ना पाए रे टिक 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 कसम ये खाए रे टिक 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 प्लास्टिक टिक ना पाए रे
फट जाएगा के बहती सी है नदिया का ये पानी रुक जाएगा
सोचो ना कोई हो एयर पॉल्यूशन जब हम कर ले एक रेजोल्यूशन सोचो होगी जिंदगी कितनी स्ट्रॉन्ग सेहत से भरी with nothing wrong सोचो कंट्रोल में रहे एक UI दिन रात दिखे सबको clear sky सोचो जब होवे कोई आविष्कार धुआं ना छोड़े कोई फैक्ट्री या कार सोचो ना
நிவேதிதா என்ன பண்றமா
எங்க காலேஜ்ல சர்வதேச அளவுல கலை விழா நடக்குது அதுக்காக நடன பயிற்சி பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கமா
என்ன நடனமா நீ படிக்கலையா
அம்மா பசங்க படிப்புல ஒரு பகுதி தான் நடனமும் அது மட்டும் இல்ல உலக பூமி நாள் என்னைக்குன்னு உங்களுக்கு தெரியுமா
என்னது உலக பூமி நாளா அப்படின்னா
நாங்க எதுக்கு இந்த நிகழ்ச்சியை பண்றோம்னா இந்த உலகத்துல இருக்கிற எல்லா நாட்டு கலாச்சாரத்தையும் பத்தி மக்களுக்கு விழிப்புணர்வு கொடுத்து அதன் மூலமா நம்ம வாழ்ற பூமியை எப்படி பாதுகாக்கிறதுன்னு எல்லாரும் தெரிஞ்சுக்கத்தான்
ஓ அப்படியா நாம வாழற பூமி நமக்கு எவ்வளவு முக்கியம்னு தெரிஞ்சுக்கவா நல்ல விஷயம்தான்
ஓகேமா எனக்கும் நேரமாச்சு
ஏ ஒரு நிமிஷம் உன்னுடைய நடனம் மூலமா நீ எந்த நாட்டு கலாச்சாரத்தை சுட்டி காட்ட போற
அதுவா ரகசியம் இப்ப நடக்கிற நிகழ்ச்சியை பார்த்து நீங்களே தெரிஞ்சுக்கோங்க
Pope Francis says, the human family has received from the Creator a common gift, nature. The entire material universe speaks of God's love, His boundless affection for us. Soil, water, mountains, everything is as it were, a caress of God. The glory of nature is perfectly reflected in the grace of our Blessed Virgin Mary. She is the masterpiece of God's creation, and eco-critics call her Green Madonna.
May the life of Blessed Mary be ever present to our awareness. In her, as in a mirror, the form of virtue and beauty of chastity shine forth. She was virgin not only in body but in mind and spirit. She was humble of heart, she was serious in her conversations, she was prudent in her counsels, she preferred to pray rather than to speak. She was ever faithful to her daily duties.
விண்ணுலக தந்தையின் அன்பு அன்னையே, இரட்சிப்பின் பாதையில் எங்கள் வாழ்வை துன்பத்தில் ஆழ்த்திவிடாமல் இயற்கை என்னும் மடியில் இன்னிசை காணாமல் தம்மை நோக்கி மன்றாடும் மக்களை நல்வழிப்படுத்தும் அன்னையே, உமக்கு நன்றி கூறுகின்றோம்.
Oh,
இறைவனின் படைப்பில் அழகானதும் அற்புதமானதும் இயற்கையே. இந்த உலகத்தில் உள்ள நாம் அனைவரும் ஒன்றிணைந்து இயற்கை வளங்களை பாதுகாத்து பூமியிலே வாழ உள்ள அடுத்த தலைமுறையினரும் இயற்கை என்னும் உன்னத இல்லத்தில் வளங்களோடு இன்புற்று வாழ பாதை அமைப்போம். அனைவரும் ஒன்றாக இணைந்து இயற்கையை பாதுகாப்போம், நலம் பெறுவோம்.
No one comes from the earth like grass. We come like trees. We all have roots. Maya Angelou. Let's all remember that our roots lie in being communion with nature, which is a theme of this academic year. Let us permit nature to have her own way.
Our planet Salam is going off and it's time to wake up and take action. The only way, if we are going to improve the quality of the environment, is to get everybody involved.
செய்தால் போதுமா?
கலங்குதே ஆலை புகையில் ஆறுதல் தேடி ஆக்சிஜனிங்கு அலருதே நதிகளை சுத்தம் செய்வோம் வா இது நம்ம பூமி இது நம்ம பூமி விதிகள் படைப்போம் விருட்சங்கள் விதைப்போம் இது நம்ம பூமி இது நம்ம பூமி இறைவன் தந்த இந்த இயற்கையினை உந்தன் நெஞ்சம் மறந்ததே சோலைவனமும் அதன் மகரந்தமும் நாம் இழந்து தவிப்பதையே
What a delightful performance by our talented Josephites. I'm sure everyone in the function felt the depth of the events and engaged in the show.
Love towards his motherland is the first dignity of a civilized man, says Napoleon Bonaparte. To evoke feelings of patriotism and remind you to the nation's glory and beauty, I request everyone to stand up in respect to our national anthem.